Welcome to a lesson on the properties of logarithms. Let's go ahead and get started. The first property is log base a of 1 is equal to 0, and this is true because a to the power of 0 will always equal 1. And if we wanted an example of this, we could say log 1 of any base, let's just say 8, will always equal 0 because a to the 0 is equal to 1. Property 2 says log base a of a is equal to 1, since a to the power of 1 will equal a. So if the base and the number are the same, it'll always equal 1. So an example of that might be log base 5 of 5 will equal 1. And then number 3, log base a of a to the power of x equals x. Well, that's true because if I take a and raise it to the power of x, it will equal a to the x. But the pattern we see here is if the base and this base are the same, it'll always just equal the exponent here. So an example of this might be log base 2 of 2 to the 7th will just equal 7 because 2 to the 7th is equal to 2 to the 7th. Okay, the three main properties we want to look at in this video are the product, quotient, and power properties of logarithms. So let's go ahead and take a look at those one at a time. The product property of logarithms states that the log of a product equals the sum of the logs. So if we have log base a of u times v, this is equal to log base a of u plus log base a of v. And we can also state the same rule using natural logs. Now, since logarithms are exponents, there's a connection between the product property for exponents and the product property for logarithms. Notice here, when you're multiplying and the bases are the same, you add your exponents. Well, here, when you're multiplying your numbers, you add your logarithms. But remember, the logarithms are exponents. So if you're multiplying, you add for both the product property of logarithms and the product property for exponents. So for example, if we had log base 5 of 6, we know we can write 6 as 2 times 3, which means you can rewrite this as log base 5 of 2 plus log base 5 of 3 using the product property of logarithms. Now, the quotient property of logarithms states the log of a quotient equals the difference of the logs. So if we have log base a of u divided by v, we can rewrite this as log base a of u minus log base a of v. And again, we can write this using natural logs as well. Again, making the connection to the quotient property of exponents, if you're dividing and the bases are the same, you subtract your exponents. So when you're dividing the numbers in the log, you would subtract your logarithms. Remember, logarithms are exponents. So for example, if we had log base 7 of, let's say, 1.5, well, 1.5 is the same as 3 halves. We could rewrite this as log base 7 of 3 minus log base 7 of 2 using the quotient property of logarithms. If you have a quotient, you can rewrite the logs as a difference. And the last property is the power property of logarithms, and it states that the log of a power equals the product of the power and the log. So log base a of u to the n power is equal to n times log base a of u. And again, we can write this using natural logs as well. The connection you can make to the power property of exponents is if you have power to a power, you multiply your exponents. Well, here if we have a log of a power, then we multiply n times the log. Well, n is an exponent, and the log is also an exponent, so we're multiplying our exponents. An example of this one might be if we have log base 12 of 5 to the 11th power, that's just equal to 11 times log base 12 of 5. There are usually two types of problems that you're asked to do to illustrate the properties of logs. The first type is to expand a log as much as possible using the properties of logs. So on this problem, the first thing we should notice is there's no rule here that deals with square roots or radicals. So let's rewrite this using rational exponents. So this is equal to log base 3 of xy cubed over z to the power of 1/2. Now we'll take this one step at a time. If we wanted to eliminate the fraction, we could rewrite this as a difference of two logs. It'll be the log of the numerator minus the log of the denominator. Let's go ahead and do that. So we'd have log base 3 of the numerator xy cubed minus log base 3 of z to the 1 half. Let's take a look at this first log. Now we have a product. So what we can do is rewrite the log of the product as the sum of two logs. So this would be equal to log base 3 of x plus log base 3 of y cubed, and then minus log base 3 of z to the 1 half. Now we can apply the power property of logs, which says we can take this exponent and move it to the front as a product, and the same thing here. So this is expanded as much as possible as log base 3 of x plus 3 times log base 3 of y minus 1 half log base 3 of z. And this is considered as expanded as possible. So we're not really solving here, we're just demonstrating that we understand these three properties. Let's go and take a look at the second type of problem, where we're given a sum or difference of logs and we want to write it as a single log. In order to utilize the product and quotient property of logarithms, the coefficients of the logs have to be 1. So we first have to utilize the power property of logs in the opposite direction that we just did. We're going to take the coefficient of the log and move it to the position of the exponent. So let's go ahead and do that first. We're going to move this 2, so it's natural log of x squared, plus, now the number here is x plus 3, so we'll take this 1/3 and move it to the position of the exponent. So we'll have natural log x plus 3 to the 1/3 power minus, take this 4, move it to the position of the exponent. So we'll have natural log of 2x to the 4th. Now let's go ahead and take this one step at a time. We can combine these two. Since it's a sum of two logs, we can multiply the number parts together. So this would be natural log x squared times x plus 3 to the power of 1/3 minus natural log 2x to the 4th. Now we have a difference of two logs, so we can combine those by writing it as a quotient. So we'll have the natural log, and then in the numerator, we're going to have x squared x plus 3 to the 1/3 power. Our denominator will be 2x raised to the power of 4. Now there is one more thing that they might try to do to us here. 2x to the power of 4 is actually 16x to the 4th. Let's take a look at this expression inside the log. We have x to the 2nd, x plus 3 to the power of 1/3. And again, our denominator would be 2x to the power of 4, that'd be 16x to the 4th. We could simplify the x squared and the x to the 4th. This would simplify out, and this would become x to the 2nd. So let's go ahead and rewrite this one more time. So we'd have the natural log x plus 3 to the 1/3 power in our numerator, and our denominator would just be 16x squared. So after combining your logs, if you can simplify this expression, you should if possible. Okay, that'll do it for this video. I hope you found it helpful. Thank you.